Well, good morning this fine Sunday, and this is Bug Eater 64, and we're getting ready to do another flight, by cracky. And getting some things done here. We're going to be flying the Bell412, and I'm going to do it, basically it's a ferry flight. I'm going to be going from a Southwest Oregon Regional to San Francisco International. We're going to be pressing the range of the Bell 412. Now the actual helicopter, our flight is going to be 375 miles with the flight plan I've set up, and in FSEconomy that is the max range for the Bell 412. Now in the real world, the Bell 412 has over 600 nautical miles of range. So I don't know why FSEconomy has shortened it by half, but it did. So we're going to see how this all goes. So let's take a look at our flight plan. And here you have it, the Sky Vector. This is Southwest Regional. And we're going to fly down and basically avoid all these mountains. Fly down along the coast and come into San Francisco here. So, shouldn't be much of a problem. Let's get into our flight. Now, where I'm sitting in South Carolina, in the upstate here, it is now 8 o'clock in the morning. So it is 5 o'clock in the morning out on the west coast, and that's why it is still dark out here. So let's go ahead, remove our before flight items. Okay, so that's good. And let's go ahead and get things set up here. Alrighty. Inverters on. Anti-collision lights. Looking pretty good. And check our throttles. Okay. And let's go ahead and... you be careful driving around my helicopter. Let's get some fuel going here. It's a fuel truck. And there's an airplane out there. Get ready to taxi. Let's get engine number one started. And that's looking good. And let's get the second engine started. A lot of activity out here this morning. Okay, looks like we've got two good engine starts. So let's get the generators on and come up here and remove our GPU. Now, figure out what I learned last night. Remember my last flight in the Bell 412, I had issues with the collective after I got through with the autopilot and tried to take back control. I had control of everything except the collective. So what I realized is that when I reloaded, so everything that happened, I'm going to tell you right now, was pilot error. It was all on me because I failed to do some things when I loaded up the aircraft, and I will show you what those were. Okay, failed to enable hardware, failed to log both for my throttles, and that's why I didn't have my HOTAS, did not have control of the throttles, and I had to use my mouse. And I did not click the force reverse collective. That's important because once I release the autopilot, this being enabled is what and today I forgot to click that. So we'll see how that goes. That may cause me some issues with my autopilot because I didn't click it before we started. But we'll find out. Alright, let's turn on that. Turn on the repeater. And go to flight plan, which is already set up. Gonna activate Oli. Very good. All right, repeater on. Okay, so let's get up to speed here. RPM's coming up. Landing light on. So we are looking good. So let's see about getting out of here and start a very long flight.
FSE flight not started.
And once again, I forgot to start the flight. I'm getting really good at this not starting a flight crud. Alright, now. So, let's try this again. Whoa, what did I do? I bet I've... Whoa, I don't know what happened there. But we got it under control now. My goodness. All right. Well, with that, let's see what we got here. All right, my goodness, what a rough start. One little more altitude. And it is, looks like it is going to track our flight plan, so that'll be good. Okay. RPM's looking good. Torque on both engines is looking good, so. Yep. Everything's looking pretty fine. Following flight plan. Very good. And let's go with altitude hold. So that's all looking very good. So our early morning flight has started, and we shall see how things all go. One thing I like about this is you come in close and you can still see all the gauges. Very cool. Okay, so we're coming up here on our first waypoint turn. And the morning commuters are already on the road. Looks like we've got a bit of a tailwind. Indicated airspeed's 120 knots. And according to our Garmin, we're doing 127. So a little over 2 hours for this flight to be completed. We should have enough fuel for that. But we shall see. See if I have to make a landing to refuel part way. Just under 4 miles to our first turn. And then the real telling tale will be once we get to where we're going, will I get the collective back? I should. In the past, flying the 412 with, you know, the hardware activated and the reverse collective, that seems to take care of you. You get out of autopilot and you get everything back, so. Okay, looks like we've got an indication the turn is coming up. 0.3 mile to go. And there we have it. So, autopilot is working. Nav is working. That's very good. And we're all set here. Everything's looking good. All right. So, with that, it's a very long flight, and it's very dark out here right now. And we're lit up like a Christmas tree so people can see us. So with that, we will see you on the far side. Enjoy the flight. Well, good morning, and the sun is coming up. So, been an uneventful flight up to this point, and we are slowly about 17 miles to our next turn. Let's take a look at the miles, and then 12 miles, and then so not that far till we get to San Francisco. The question is still, are we going to have enough fuel? We're getting down to, won't be long now, we'll get a little message here saying low fuel. But we'll see how things go. Like I said, we're pushing the endurance. According to FSEconomy, we're pushing the endurance of this helicopter. Yet in the real world, we'd only been using half a tank of our fuel at the point we get to San Francisco. We'll just keep pushing along and see how things go. Looks like a beautiful morning, though. And we're out over the coast. 992. Okay. Okay, so altimeter set.
San Francisco INTL Information Hotel. 1400 Zulu weather. Wind calm, visibility 10. Sky clear, temperature 14, dew point 5. Altimeter 2992. Arriving runways 28 left, 28 right. Departing runways 28 left, 28 right, 01 right, 01 left. Advise on initial contact you have hotel.
Okay, so we've got everything set up. Okay, so we are looking very good. About 3.5 miles to our turn. And we'll get ready to start our turn inland towards San Francisco International. And here we go. And I think I can just barely see the beginning of the Golden Gate. Interesting. Beginning to see as the Golden Gate and the city of San Francisco as it comes out of the haze. Still a distance away. As the sun continues to rise in this good morning. Thank you, my good co-pilot. It's time for a little Hotel Charlie. Nectar of the gods. Okay, about 9.5 miles to our final waypoint before we go actually into the airport. Yep, I've got my low fuel warning. But we are committed at this point. Just after 8 o'clock, California time. And there's the Golden Gate and island in the middle of the bay there for Alcatraz. Looks like that may possibly be the airport. Feet. That's what I need to know. Okay, we're about 9 miles from the airport. Okay. Yep, that'd be the airport. Oh, yeah. Yep. We are getting there. Got it slowed down to 60 knots. Okay. Okay, so we are down. We made the complete flight, 375 miles on one tank of fuel. What have we got left? 19. So, yeah, took it right down to the wire. Okay, and let's go ahead and come on. And we'll go ahead and finish the flight, even if it was a non-paid flight. And then Well, all right, there you have it. We are sitting safely in San Francisco, so now we can pick up some jobs and actually maybe start making a little money with this helicopter. But very good flight. We also got some good information on the endurance. 375 miles would be just about the maximum for it in FS Economy. I don't know why they've cut the endurance, flight endurance distance in half of what the real helicopter can do. But it is what it is, and that's what we have to live with. So we'll do it. No big issue there at all. The one thing, I thought I was going to run into the same problem with the collective issue, but what happened is you've got to match your collective with the collective that's in the aircraft itself. If you're using a like I use a Warthog HOTAS with my system, and at first, and that's why you saw that big jerk with the helicopter, because that first I had to adjust and find out where my collective was with the collective already in the aircraft. And once the two of them synced up, then I had my collective control back. So that was that issue. But other than that, everything worked fine. Worked just the way it's supposed to. We're here in San Francisco, so all is well. So as long as I've got my plug-in set up, you know, my 412 with my hardware set up and my throttles, and especially this one, Force Reverse Collective. That's the one I really need to make sure I've got, and I shouldn't have to click on it again because it's already being used, and the helicopter will fly just fine. So with that, hope you enjoyed the flight. It was a long flight, not for you guys, of course, but just about 3 hours, maybe a few minutes longer than that, and went very well, though. Completely uneventful. So until next time, this is Bug Eater 64. Glad you came along with me. Hope you sure enjoyed the flight, because I sure had fun bringing it to you. And if you liked it, please click the like button. If you didn't like it, click the don't like button. And if you feel up to it, leave me some comments. I've had some great comments from subscribers recently that have been super helpful and actually made me flying, me as a pilot, better in the simulation. So thank you again to everybody, and look forward to hearing from you very, very soon. So, as always, remember, safe flying.